matters. Okay, doors closed at the back. Are we all in? Everybody safe? Ready for the start of the show?
Okay.
Good, yeah, health and safety. Are we all in party mood?
Yeah!
Sorry, what was that?
Yeah!
Better, that's better. Okay, if we have half the fun as we had last night, we're going to have a good night. I'm going to start it off by just introducing the man who's MC for the evening. You'll be pleased to know it's not me. Please give him a big welcome, Mr. Mike George.
Thank you. Thank you. Was it an honour? What an honour. It is an honour to be here. I was here last night. What a night you're in for. Oh my God, there's not a sane brain amongst them. Welcome to the Courtyard. It's an evening of fun and laughter and entertainment. It's a hats off to the hospice, in other words. Hey. We must not forget why we're here, and that's to raise as much money as possible for St Michael's Hospice. There aren't many here tonight who haven't had, at some stage, known someone who's been in the hospice, and the reason we're here tonight really is because two of the band members lost loved ones who spent their last few weeks in the hospice, and they have first-hand knowledge of what a caring place it is. People don't go there to die, they go there to live. And if you haven't been there, let me assure you, it is filled with joy and happiness. It is an incredible place. Enough of me for the time being, anyway. Let's meet the band. Last performed together nearly 20 years ago. They stayed in touch. They've been practicing for two or three minutes. Firstly, ladies and gentlemen, proof positive that life is like a hot bath. The longer you're in it, the more wrinkled you get. Charles with the lovely Tish. Doctor in the house, isn't it? And now the man who's at the stage of life when he bends down to tie his shoes, he wonders if there's anything else he should be doing while he's down there. Pikey Mullens! The third quarter of the hat band. I've known for about 30 years. He used to regularly appear on my shows. God bless our wonderful dog, Harper, who in fact became more famous than I ever was. Got asked to open Fates and the like. And the man who made me cry on air when he related the poem that gets you over a dead dog, and it really is quite moving. In fact, hairs on the back of my neck have gone up even now. He also taught me a salutary lesson. Never, ever shake hands with a vet. George Cooper, ladies and gentlemen. Finally, the baby of the band, the man who can do a great impression of Rob Brydon, and the man who's in charge of sex and drugs for the whole of the band. He reminds them of what the former is like, and as far as the latter is concerned, he distributes their medication at the appropriate time. Ladies and gentlemen, Rob Williams! Now, ladies and gentlemen, sit back. Enjoy yourself. You're in for a cracking evening. You really are. And may I just also say, for God's sake, do as you're told. All right? They've been away too long, ladies and gentlemen. The Hat Band.
Now, you may have noticed that there were two sort of elements of decrepitude in here and two that sort of strolled on. Ain't Botox wonderful?
Notice you didn't mention the Viagra there, Meg, did you?
Sorry, that's rude. Let's take a little thing. How are you doing? Are you all right?
Yes!
Do you want to have some fun tonight?
Yes!
Well, you'll be lucky to get out before midnight, but we'll do our best to get you home in time for cocoa and the slippers before we go. Are we all right then? Let's have a big cheer for Mike George, please. This is
our first of our many sea songs tonight, and we'd like you all to join in with us if you know the words. If you don't, take off your shoes and hum. Songs, why I don't bite my fingernails. You've seen what vets do at the back end of cars. Cows, not cars, cows. That's why I don't bite my fingernails. It's got ever such a difficult guitar part. Thank you.
date. Won't recognise actions the byword of late. For every task we've a gadget to match, and our new Max Spreader be the best of the batch.
Click it here,
this is your turn.
Click it here,
all together now. And if you're standing round, then you'll all get your share.
Right in the eye.
Now young Walter Rushkins were driving in a load of liquid manure from the farm down the road. He to himself as he drove it along, and his load also in the afternoon sun.
Fling it here, all together now, fling it here, stand along please. And if you're standing round, then you'll all get your share.
Now the muck spreader had a mechanical fault, and a bump in the road turned it on with a jolt. A stream of manure at once it let fly, without fear or favour on all what passed by.
Come along please,
sing you buggers!
And if you're standing round, then you'll all get your share.
Sing!
Laugh and sing at the same time. I can see you.
Now the cats and the dogs thanked to High Kingdom come, and the kiddies browned off, ran on screaming to mum. The trail of sheer havoc were terrible grim. George's open car got filled right to the brim.
Sing it here, sing along please, sing it here.
You sing it.
And if you're standing round, then you'll all get your share.
In her garden, Miss Pringle were quite scandalised. She cried, I have been fertilised. The Methodist minister's teetotal wife were plastered for the very first time in her life.
Fling it here, fling it there. And if you're standing round, then you'll all get your share.
Religious verse, especially for Mullens, who has been known to yell,
Alleluia!
Alleluia!
Amen!
The vicarage windows were opened quite wide, when a generous portion descended inside. The vicar at dinner intoned, let us pray. When this man you're from heaven came flying his way.
Fling it here, fling it here. And if you're standing round, then you'll all get your share.
Now meanwhile young Walter was still driving along. He was quite unaware there were anything wrong, till a figure of woe flagged him down. What a sight! A policeman all covered in...
Yes, you got it right! Fling it here, fling it there.
And if you're standing round, then you'll all get your share.
Bring it here, bring it there.
And if you're standing round, then you'll all get your share.
we had these hats made. These hats have been made specially for us from Emma, who works in the box office. Let's have a round of applause for Emma and her hats. The trouble is, they're not made to do this with. Because otherwise everything ends up in a heap on the floor. Has Charles left us yet?
He has. He's over there.
He left.
Thank God for that.
Enjoy it whilst it lasts.
Yes. You have to understand, I mean, we've been singing together for 35 years. And, well, the thing is that we try to keep Charles from singing. We've tried everything.
So we thought that this was the best song for him when he has to sing it in the dark.
Yep.
This is your turn. This is when you get your torches out. So please, guttle in your handbags, in your drawers, wherever they might be. Yeah, let's have your torches out. And I hope you've all got your hats on your heads as well. Because this is an integral part of this song. Okay? It's amazing how many children there are in this audience tonight. So, have you got your torches? Have you got your torches?
Yeah!
Have you all got your torches?
Yeah!
There's someone there with a World War II spotlight down there. Now, the point of this song is it's an OAP song. And since Chuck, now listen or you'll not know what you're doing. I shall have to get Uncle Bryn to turf you all out. The point of this song is it's a song about an OAP who hasn't got any teeth. And you're going to be singing this with us. Oh, yes, you are. You can go now, because I'm not doing any more. Now, what you have to do here is pretend you're an OAP without any teeth. So you're going to be singing like this. Hello, everybody. Like that. So I want you to say, on the count of three, I want to say, hello, hat band, back to us, okay? One, two, three.
Hello, hat band.
I still saw some teeth shining in the darkness. You know, we want to see everyone just using your torch. You can turn them off if you want, because I'm going to show you what to do in a minute.
Let me take the teeth out, George.
Now listen, you're on dangerous footing down there, giving me an answering back from their bollocks, girth. You better watch it. Now that I know where you're sat, mate, these are my own teeth apart from these ones. But I can't take them out. Shut your face. Anyway, who invited you? The point about this is, hello, hat band. And Charles is going to sing the song about the man without false teeth. But there's a chorus. Oh, yes. We'd like you to join in. And I have to put my glasses on for this bit. One of the things about increasing age. The chorus goes like this. In gilly gilly salt and pepper, have a cup of coffee by the sea. Because I didn't know what the right words were. So let's all try it together. Like this, all right, like that. In gilly gilly salt and pepper, have a cup of coffee by the sea. Okay, fairly bloody average, but we'll try it again. Are you ready for this? No, are you ready for this? In gilly gilly salt and pepper, have a cup of coffee by the sea. Good. Let's have the lights out and a big courtyard welcome for Mr. Charles OAP Sanders! Keep it going because he's going to take quite a time to get here. Torch as well, there we go. Incidentally, you might care to wind your torches up. I'm not stupid, I'm not going to waste money on batteries. I'm Scottish. Now, the point of this, turn your torches off! Turn your torches off! What is it that's so difficult to understand between turn and off? Right, this is Charles Sanders' song. Take it away, Charles.
Good evening.
Are you shitting?
Turn it off! Your turn won't come!
Go!
Go!
In the tiny...
Whoa. Oh,
hang on! In the tiny house!
In the tiny house!
Now, whoa! The whole idea there is that you light yourselves up from under there as you sing the song with us. So when Charles sings the line, then we all do this and we give him his line back again. Do you understand?
Yes!
Do you understand, Charles?
Yes.
Right, torches off!
It's difficult.
Just, if you can't find the switch, put it between your legs.
Carefully.
Right, Charles?
In the tiny house.
In the tiny house.
Start again! They're filming it, sorry, keep going.
In the tiny house.
In the tiny house.
By a tiny stream.
By a tiny stream.
Lived an OAP. With the sight.
With his lifelong dream
To go by bus
To tell the bus
Where he wanted to go Without making a fuss He tried every week But no one understood.
Gilly, salt and pepper. Have a cup of coffee by the sea.
Then a fairy queen Landed in the spring Saw the OAP With his lifelong dream She gave him some dentures.
Ding! Shine your torch on him! He's got dentures! Yes!
And all his dreams came true. He went to Gilly Gilly, got some pepper, have a cup of coffee by the sea.
And it'll be on Facebook tomorrow, I promise you.
It might be funny from your aspect looking this way, from our aspect looking that way.
I thought, who brought all these Chinese lanterns in? Gee, we can move quite quickly when he wants to.
Still getting your slippers on.
come back, we're a long way away. Oh God, he's disappeared. You start this one as well, we've got to wait for him. All the doggies held the meeting, they came from near and far. Some came by motorcycle and some by motor car. Each doggie passed the entrance, each doggie signed the book, and each unzipped his whatsit and hung it on a hook. Now one dog was not invited, it sorely raised his ire. So he rushed into the meeting hall and loudly shouted, "Fire!" Without a second column, without a second look, each doggy grabbed someone else's thing from off its other hook.
And that's the reason why, sir, when walking down the street. And that's the reason why, sir, when doggies chance to meet. And that's the reason why, sir, on land or sea or foam, he will sniff another's what's it to see if it's his own! That's called a filler. We're supposed to be out of here by 11:10, yes. Fine felt hat, Charles, about a fiddler. Lost a lot of weight, they haven't been able to cook for a week.
Now,
this is an interesting song. It's an American folk song. It's a song about going on a voyage, and you might recognize some of this because it's quite well known. I wish I had a haircut. I put a notice on Facebook last week saying, hippie or haircut, hippie or haircut, hippie or haircut, and the answer was all hippie. So I left it as it was. Pay attention to Facebook.
was the very same thing in red. I wanna go home. I wanna go home. I feel so broken. I wanna go home.
Said the vicar, it's time that you ceased treating your suffering wife like a beast. He cried out, God rest us, you sprayed me with domestos, you'll be charged
with the bleach of the priest. I wanna go home, I wanna go home. I feel so broken, I wanna go home.
We were making 10 knots, sailing the 7 seas.
Oh, we were.
Oh, we were getting near Treasure Island, and we thought it was uninhabited, but it wasn't uninhabited. There was a lonely sailor there who'd had a terrible, terrible accident.
Are you ready?
And then we saw he wasn't alone. He'd got his parrot for company. It was, of course, it was the one, the only, Long John Silver!
My neighbor's got a dog called Don, who likes a bone to chew on. I gave myself a fright in the middle of the night when I noticed half my leg had gone.
I wanna go home. I wanna go home. I feel so broken. I wanna go home.
When I've a headache that begins to roll, to the chemist I do stroll. He thinks it's bad, all the pills that I've had, but the parrot said them all.
I wanna go home. I wanna go home. I feel so broken. I wanna go home.
Well, the parrot, well, he's me mate, and the stories he could relate. I know that he would, if only he could, but all he says, it beats in the face.
I wanna go home, I wanna go home. I feel so broken, I wanna go home.
Take a lesson from Blackbeard's book, as to hospital he was took. If your cheeks start to twitch with an embarrassing itch, use your finger, but never your hook.
I wanna go home. I wanna go home. I feel so broken. I wanna go home.
I forgot my words. Better. I've got myself a gun. Me parrot, I depend, for I haven't got many friends. No, it's worse than that. I know that I'd cry if he happened to die, but I know he only pretends.
I wanna go home. I wanna go home.
Clap your hands!
Are you going to tell them about me being a foxy?
Oh, yeah.
Are you?
Oh, yeah.
Well, the first thing I'm going to do right now is blow my nose. Those of us who are over 60 in the audience know that your nose drips, doesn't it? Your nose! And I found last night I couldn't sing some of the songs because I was going through everything like this. My nose was dripping.
You were crying when you heard me sing.
As well. Pikey here. Proper name Mike. People call him Pike. I don't know, dyslexic down in Sussex, I think. He used to be a folk singer. Now, does anybody here know anything about folk music? Are there any folkies in the audience? Just put your hand up, I can see you. And if I can't, torch, I can see you like this. Folk singers, I'm not sure whether they like to hear what they're singing or if they don't like what they're listening to, but they put their finger in the ear like that. I think it's to drown out half the sound that they're listening to. It might be the other people that they're trying to avoid. So this is just to show you that we're not just pretty faces, this particular song. Some might say not even pretty faces. But this is, especially for the folk ethnics in the audience, and Pikey, this is an, difficult to get this right, an unaccompanied ethnic finger in the ear, tear jerking, unaccompanied folk song. Are you ready?
Yes!
Good, come join us! You haven't got your shoes on?
Don't worry about that.
All right then, I'll worry. I'm not worried about that. This is an ethnic, unaccompanied, finger-in-the-ear, tear-jerking folk song that we hope you'll enjoy and you join in with. Just a word of warning for those on that side of the house. Watch out. Catch it if you can. You've turned it off, haven't you?
In Dublin's fair city, where the girls are so pretty, I first set my eyes on sweet Molly Malone. As she wheeled a wheelbarrow through streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh. She was a fishmonger, and sure it was no wonder, for so were her father and mother before. And they all wheeled their barrows through streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh. She died
alone. Now a ghost wheels at
streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive,
one more time.
Most tennis players at the end of the match always put one in the audience.
I've seen them.
Tennis balls.
20 years since we played.
Not bad, eh, so far?
I tell you what, when we got together with this daft idea to put on these concerts, we got together in Charles's house. Mick wasn't here because he lives in East Sussex. And he couldn't be asked to come up for the particular rehearsal that particular night. And the three of us got together with Tish and we laughed and we laughed. And the energy was still there, like it was all those years ago. The fact that we all had to lie down half an hour later.
So, we're going to try and remember this first song. Last night, a complete failure.
Is it an instrumental?
But they thought it was part of
excuse
the
me.
But it wasn't.
Excuse me, is it an instrumental?
I've got an instrument down here.
I got the wrong program.
Oh. Yeah. But you wrote them.
Yeah, I know.
But you have to do it over yeah. here.
That's from 20... Oh, no. Oh, okay.
We're going to have a we're not sure about this first.
My umbilical cord. It's in orange so I can see it.
Thank you. Well, you weren't in that one.
It's a gin and orange.
There's vodka and orange.
Okay.
That's enough.
I took you seriously, I just took a gulp.
Just want to make sure they're enjoying themselves at that.
You know I wear all these glasses, but it's my friends here know I have to have them for the goal. I use it each pair has a different club, you know. And tonight I'm not playing. I use those binoculars when I drive.
Yeah. He tried these varifocals on the other day.
Oh, don't!
And we thought he was, you know, agreeing with everything we said. He was just trying to get in focus.
Things they ask you to do.
I'm not plugged in.
I'm not plugged in.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Here we go. It's going in. Now!
It stops the Big Bang, okay? Those who know about electrics. Well, that's what he tells me.
Have you turned it off?
I told it. He's waiting for a signal. Yeah, you don't really mind his playing, okay?
What's wrong?
That's our special effects machine, okay?
Just talk amongst yourselves, really. Stop staring at me.
Has Richard found his tickets yet? Are these seats still empty? Because they won't let you in. I checked.
Is that on?
Yeah.
Right, well, I can't hear anything from it. Change the other one.
Change the other one. Hey, plug!
Okay, here we go. It's the other one now! Right. Now, at this point, we need the lighting down a bit. And green! We're going to Gay Paris. We're going to where the man committed suicide by jumping off a bridge and he was declared insane. That's an intelligent joke. Really green.
Night when the barman said quasi and teachers all right. Teachers is fine and I know that it sells, but when it's for quasi it's gotta be bells. My wife went to church, the vicar to tell. This Sunday morning there won't be a bell. She said to the vicar, don't give Quasi the sack. He can't come today cause he's got a bad back.
Jim, Jiminy, Jim, Jiminy, Jim, 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 it's the one.
If you don't say I'm chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim chiror, that I am a sweep who just happens to be poor. I'll ask George Cooper, cause I know he's a mate, if he'll lend me a quid until I get straight.
Chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim chiroo, he is the one who will clean out your flu. Chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim chiroo, give it the hump if you don't sing out
face when I found that the wok was not in its place. We're not having Chinese, my wife did assert. The wok comes in useful for ironing your shirt.
Chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim chiroo, he is the one who will clean out your flu. Chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim chiroo, he'll get the hump if you don't sing that poo.
Chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim chiree, I went down the cafe for a nice cup of tea. Chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim chiroo, the waitress asked kindly, is it one lump or two?
Chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim chiroo, he is the one who will clean out your flu. Chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim chiroo, he'll get the hump if you don't sing a tune. Chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim chiroo, he is the one who will clean up your flu. Chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim chiroo, he'll get the hump if you don't sing.
They didn't fall all the way to the floor. We once did that, and all he used to wear was a pair of tights, rather than before he took to wearing the shorts, and we used to have a set of spotlights that shot up at us from down there, and we were standing over, and I tell you what, I'm glad he wears shorts from now on.
We were all married.
Incidentally, nowadays, you've probably been used to the adverts and the letters in the Hereford Times asking to see if we can find some red trousers. Because our trademark used to be red trousers, white shirts and red tie. Well, I will tell you, we have scoured the internet globally and been unable to find any red trousers that fitted. So, we were very lucky, we got in contact with a company, I don't know how, a company called Joseph Turner from somewhere up in Yorkshire, who agreed to sponsor us, as it says in the programme, and they sent us these lovely red shirts, pink, and these lovely stone chinos, so I think they deserve a round of applause! Don't overdo it now. The interesting thing was that these only arrived last night at about 6 o'clock. They were couriered in, especially for us, all the way from China to get here in time, because they'd run out of their factory and they sent off to China, so some little Chinese man was... So there we are. We've got our outfits to wear for you tonight. Do you like them?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so glad.
The only reason they did it was they were terrified we'd come on the stage naked, you know.
I don't think the Chinese would be worried about it.
Is that working yet?
No.
were stuffed on that one, so we'll do another one. Never mind. I'm just as happy on this guitar. This is just as nice a new guitar. I still can't play the bloody thing. It stayed in tune for the first half. Okay. This is a rather nice song that we like to sing. It's a song that Michael and I used to sing many years ago when we were singing in the women's institutes and the pubs. And when we were out singing to the Women's Institute, God bless them, they were the ones in the calendar, girls, at a wonderful time. We sang this song and we always thought of our children back home, tucked up in bed, because this is a lullaby that we're going to sing. And it's a lovely song with some lovely harmonies, provided we get it right, and we'd like you to enjoy it with us.
Doesn't it?
Do you know, I've never seen that. I've never seen it except on video because I can't turn round.
You're turning round now. What's the matter with you? Oh, I see it all because it's on. We used to get called off for that. We're doing that. We had one chap called Tony Mortimer, God bless him. He got cross with us for spoiling a proper folk song by putting all this silly stuff behind us. So I said, go get real, my friend. My God. We're nearly finished. This is our main claim to fame. Yes, you know what's coming. We performed this song live on Chris Tarrant's breakfast show on Capital Radio in London. It was better than that. From a phone box in Hereford. This fits in with our perennial farming theme with muck and stuff. This is a song of a mighty farm bird who's not ready yet. This is the song of the bantam cock. And if you can't see down here because of me and all this, stand up and move to the side. Use your initiative. You're missing the best bit. This bird knew what it wanted.
Oh, yeah.
This bird, more often than not, got what it wanted. Was it satisfied?
No.
Did it want more?
Oh.
And more? Yeah. And more? We'll sing the song. It was out. Fine. Helps if you get the right key to sing it in. We haven't done this for 20 years, so do excuse me. If I flap my arms too much, moths will fly out. Was a fine, upstanding bantam cock, so brisk and stiff and spry, with a springy step and a jaunty bloom and a purposeful look in his eye. His little like a blinking eye. I forgot to warn you, not only are there sound effects, the bugger's amplified tonight too. I took him to the coop and introduced him to the 17 wide-eyed hens. He upped and he topped like a hero tops. And he bowed from the waist and then. He upped and he had them all again, he did. He jumped, me giggling guinea fowl. He jumped, me giggling guinea fowl, and he thrust his attentions upon me 12 hysterical turkeys and. Visiting migrant swans.
Hey, 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 hey.
And the bantam thundered on, he did thunder. Thunder!
He ravished me fantail pigeons and...
Look at the pool! Look at the pool! Look at the pool! Ow!
He ravished me fantail pigeons and... Me lily white columbine. And while I was locking up my budgerigar. He had me parrot from behind.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Who was sitting on me shoulder at the time? When all of a sudden, with a gasp and a gulp, he's clapped his wings to his head and flattened on his back with his feet in the
going to the hospice or to the Bracken Trust if you want to buy a copy of our songbook. There it is. You can use it for what you like. Goes all right, hung up by a corner in the littlest room in the house.
We don't come with it, though. I'm sorry. We're not for auction.
This is the last song of the first half And then Michael is coming on to explain the intricacies of the draw. So this is a lovely song called Athens Drive.
let's only run.